Good morning, everyone. The National Council for Educational Research and Training heartily welcomes all of you to the National Yoga Olympiad 2019. As you all know, NCERT, on the behalf of Ministry of Human Resource Development, has initiated Yoga Olympiad to promote yoga in schools. It has been started in 2016 and since then been organizing successfully from the last 4 years as a follow-up to the International Day of Yoga observed on 21st of June. This year also, National Yoga Olympiad organized by NCERT from 18th to 20th of June in New Delhi with a theme of Yoga for Health and Harmony to generate awareness about yoga among children and to build team spirit and also the confidence, which further will teach all of us the holistic way of living and also to promote peaceful living in the society. With a quote from the Bhagavad Gita, yoga is the journey to the self, through the self and to the self. Iska matlab hai, yog swayam ke madhyam se, swayam ke liye aur swayam ki yatra hai. With this positive quote, let's proceed to the sub-event of lighting the lamp. Thank you, sir. Now I request the students of DMS RIE from Bhopal to please perform a welcome song to create an arena full of positivity.
Thank you.
let's hear the jingle on yoga.
योग ओलंपियाड NCERT द्वारा आयोजित मानव संसाधन विकास मंत्रालय भारत सरकार के सौजन्य से 18 से 20 जून 2019 नई दिल्ली में योग ओलंपियाड। Yoga Olympiad, organized by NCERT, by the initiative of the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, 18th to 20th June 2019, in New Delhi. Yoga Olympiad. Yoga!
Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Eric Holt, Director, UNESCO, New Delhi, Dr. Huma Masood from UNESCO, my colleague, Joint Director CIT, Professor Behra, Professor Saroj Yadav, Dean Academic, Major Harsh Kumar, Secretary NCERT, Honorable Members of Jury, my dear colleagues, teachers, students who have come from different part of the country, I take this opportunity to welcome you all to this event, particularly Yoga Olympiad, what we have been organizing for last 4 years. We started this program in 2016. 21 states participated in this program. Then in 17, 25 states participated. Then in 18, 28 states participated, and this year you will be happy to know that 33 states have participated in this event. It shows that we are making yoga popular day by day. More number of students, more number of teachers, more number of institutions are participating in this event. This is a great opportunity for all of us. We are trying our best to make yoga popular so that our children will be benefited, because we all know yoga means unite, join or unite. It has been derived from Sanskrit word, and by practicing yoga, what we can do, we can help our students to unite their body with their consciousness, and we can unite ourselves with the whole world, not only with our consciousness but also with the whole world and with the nature. We all know this yoga practice is very old. It is an integral part of ancient Indian tradition, and this is not only physical It is physical, mental and spiritual practice, and it originated in India. And we are very happy that our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji has made it popular all over the world. You all know in 2015, 21st June was declared by United Nations as the International Yoga Day. And from that day onwards, we have been conducting this program, and successfully we have been conducting this program. Students, teachers from all over the country are participating. I take this opportunity to congratulate my dear students who have come from different parts of the country to participate in this event. They have come to this stage because they have participated in block level, in district level, then state level, then they have come to national level. I request all of you to give a big hand to the children who are participating and the teachers who have accompanied the students, who have been motivating them to participate in these events, because all the time we say that our tradition is very rich, our culture is very rich, but now time has come to understand our culture. Yoga is an integral part of our culture. That is why, by making it popular, by integrating in school curriculum, we can help our students to practice yoga. We can make them good citizens, we can make them good human beings, because we all know that all the time our focus is on living together. In ancient time we have been saying that Vasudeva Kutumbakam, from ancient time. And what is this? And in Delor Commission report you will find learning to live together. And now through yoga we can achieve this, we can unite ourselves with the whole world. Now whole world is celebrating this yoga, International Day of Yoga, and we have taken it to all the people of the world. And I hope within few years we can actually help our students to understand the spirit of yoga. Not only the Indian students, the students all over the world will understand the spirit of yoga. Yoga will be popular and we can achieve world peace, and we can prepare good human being, and that is good citizen for this country, and that will be significant contribution for the mankind. That is the purpose. That is why we have developed textbook and we have integrated it into our curriculum, and in future we'll try our best to make it more popular and help everybody to practice yoga. That is, with that intention we are conducting this program. I hope you all will take advantage of this event, and I request my colleagues to observe all the events, because students who have come from different part of the country, and their performance should be observed by everybody, and we should learn from them and we should encourage them, and this will be a great motivation to the students who have come from different part of the country. And I once again welcome you all to this program. I hope we can achieve the objective, because we all the time say we should go beyond textbook, we should go beyond curriculum. And this is by conducting such type of program. It may be Yoga Olympiad, it may be Kala Uchav. By conducting such type of program, practically we are going beyond curriculum, we are going beyond textbook, and we are creating a different type of environment, learning environment for our students, so that they can develop all their innate potentialities. Not only they will prepare for exam, they will develop all their innate potentialities. You know, in 21st century skills, UNESCO has highlighted that our children should be more creative, they should develop critical thinking, problem solving ability. All these will be possible through yoga, because yoga helps us to develop concentration. To do anything we need concentration, and since we need concentration we have to practice yoga, and we have to promote yoga, we have to create awareness for yoga. then only we can achieve the objective and it will serve the purpose. And I once again I welcome you all to this event and I hope you will enjoy this program. Thank you.
Good morning to everyone. Respected Chief Guest Shri Eric Falk, Director and UNESCO Representative from India for India, Bhutan, Maldives and Sri Lanka. Respected Director NCERT Professor Hrushikesh Senapati ji, Professor Amrendra Behra, Joint Director CIT, Ms. Uma Masood, UNESCO, Secretary NCERT, all the jury members, chairpersons of various committees, heads of the department, my own colleague, faculty from NCERT, teachers, students and other dignitaries. I think this is the fourth time we are organizing this Yoga Olympiad. And as the director has very rightly said, that yoga, which has come from a Sanskrit word, means integration of body, mind and soul together. Some people used to say yoga is an end. Some used to say yoga is a means. But it is both. It is an end because it will help us in integration of the body, mind and soul. And it is a means because through various activities, yogic practices, we use to achieve that highest integration at the body, mind and soul. So yoga is not only, you can say, in India now. It has spread all over the world. And they very much, the Gita has said, Vasudev Kutumbakam. So yoga is uniting the whole world together. And that is the result that on 11th December 2014, the United Nations General Assembly with 193 members approved the proposal to observe 21st June as the International Day of Yoga. In, you can say, as a follow-up, on 1st December 2016, UNESCO inscribed yoga in its list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity. So in a way, the yoga is not only some activities. I think that also we have to be very clear. Just asana and pranayama is not yoga. Yoga also includes your ahara, your vichara, what you eat, how do you behave in the society. And I think with this objective we have started the Yoga Olympiad because you children constitute a larger proportion of our population. 65% of the population of India is below 35 years of age and 50% below 25 years of age. So you are going to, you can say, what will be the shape of the economy will depend on you. And where now, just now we were talking, the Joint Director CIT Professor Amrendra Behra said, it is not only health promoting, but it will also promote employment opportunities. Because so many yoga teachers, instructors and you can say gurus are needed now. So it is going to become a trillion economy and employment generation economy also. So with this, I think this Yoga Olympiad we have started. The objective of Yoga Olympiad is not to only give you the knowledge, because knowledge is enough. It is only to practice and you have to practice self. There is no cost of, you can say, practicing self. So it gives you the health, and health is not only physical but emotional stability and alertness of the mind is very important, because these days the children, the young population is also harming self and indulging in some of the unwanted, you can say, activities. So yoga can help us to develop holistically both physical, mental and emotional health. So this is the, you can say, fourth time. As the director has already said, the number of states are increasing. This shows the number of students who are participating in this Olympiad are increasing, and at the national level it is only the glimpse of the, you can say, the whole population, because we are organizing this Yoga Olympiad as per our scheme from school to the district level, to district to the state level, and those winning team, only four in each category, that is four students in the upper primary as boys and four as a girls. Similarly, four students at the secondary stage as boys and four students at the secondary stage as girls are participating. So this is the limited number, and if we count that the number is about 630. So the number is increasing, the number of states are increasing, and for the first time we have included CBSE also, the school of CBSE, the school of Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, the school of Navodaya Vidyalaya Samiti. So we have included in our own regional Institute of Education demonstration multi-purpose school. So in a way we have spread the message. I think message is that we have to do yoga at the school level, and the practice which the jury will see that it is not one day effort. It means it has already become a part and parcel of their curriculum, their school syllabi and textbooks. We have already developed the textbooks, and those are very simple steps have been given in the textbooks. So I hope you are following those textbooks. So with this I say that in this Olympiad you will be judged on the basis of asan, pranayams and kriyas. Some asans will be given by the jury member and some will be given by yourself. So you can select your own asan. Similarly with the pranayam and similarly with the kriya. You will be judged by a jury of three jury members, and I think all jury members are totally fair. So don't think that somebody is giving some fair to the others. You all are winners because you have reached to the national level. So best of luck to everyone, and I hope you will definitely enjoy and you will spread the message of Yoga Olympiad, because Yoga Olympiad, through doing yoga activities, we can achieve our holistic health. Thank you so much.
Dr. Ruhikesh Senapati, Director, NCERT. Dr. Saroj Yadav, Dean Academic, NCERT. Teachers, principals, and students from different states of India. I can hear you loud and clear in the back. Can you hear me as well? Yes? Okay. Well, this is my second year as part of the Yoga Day celebrations at NCERT. And I'm very pleased to be among all of you again. India, as the birthplace of yoga, has a very unique position in terms of pursuing happiness, well-being and mindfulness. International Yoga Day is a great initiative of the Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi, and UNESCO is always very proud to associate with this day. I know that there's a number of events that are organized throughout the city here in New Delhi, but also throughout the country and also around the world. So this is a privilege to be with you this morning, focusing more specifically on the place of yoga in education systems. As already mentioned, there's a very close association between UNESCO and yoga, since back in 2016, only 3 years ago, yoga was inscribed on UNESCO's representative list of the intangible cultural heritage of humanity. Over recent decades, there's no doubt that access to education has expanded significantly throughout the world. Primary education has become virtually universal in many countries, including obviously in India, and more countries are achieving universal basic education, extending their coverage to secondary education as well. However, I'm sure you're all aware, and I know that this will strike a chord in particular with teachers, there is a concern around the world that education systems are becoming overly competitive, stress-fueled, and too often test-focused. We're aware that most of the time developing conducive environments to learning are easily forgotten in a highly competitive environment. Among the youth of today, we also see trends of intolerance and violent extremism on the one hand, and increasing levels of anxiety and depression among too many students on the other hand. Our experts are actually alarmed that school attendance is, for many students, not a positive experience. The reasons for these trends are many and complex, but clearly something must be done to redefine the purpose of school education and rethink our schools in the 21st century. And I know that NCERT is at the forefront of this particular struggle. The appeal to rethink school education, some of you may know, was actually the title of a publication by our colleagues from NGIEP, the Mahatma Gandhi Institute for Peace, Education of Peace for Unsustainable Development. This particular publication illustrates vividly the challenges of competitiveness and regimentation confronting school education across for Asia, and actually call for new formulas to be used. For those of you who have not had a chance to read through this publication, particularly educationists, please have a look at it, because we hope that will inspire you. I certainly believe, like all of my UNESCO colleagues, that no one practice can change the situation that I've just described, but certainly that is where yoga comes into being. There is a growing body of research which shows that yoga can improve mental, emotional, physical, and behavioral health in school-age children. Yoga also has the benefit of a very long history and a very rich heritage. And many schools in India have introduced yoga in very early ages and a long time ago. What we're seeing with initiatives like the one pioneered by NCERT is actually a mainstreaming of yoga in many schools, and that is something that we would like to very much encourage. Yoga reaches beyond gender, beyond culture, beyond language, and if understood correctly, it also reaches beyond age and ability, and socially it's also a great equalizer. So there are many benefits to yoga, and the Prime Minister of India, Prime Minister Modi, certainly set the tone and gave an example, inspiring example for the rest of the world. Here in India we see yoga rolled out very rapidly in many more schools, and I see many more students here that we had last year, so I'm sure that's an indication of the success of your initiative, and I would like to commend NCERT again. Altogether, I want to congratulate the Ministry of Human Resource Development and CERT for actually constantly redefining education and taking initiatives that are clearly in the interest of Indian students through curriculum reforms. This is something that is often unseen in society, but I'm happy to be with you to celebrate not only International Yoga Day, but also the many initiatives that you take. This is actually a yearly appointment with you, among many others, and I'm happy to be here. I'm sure that the students who have come from many parts of India, all parts of India, all regions of India, will enjoy today's event. I'm sure also that teachers, parents, and educationists present here will take stock together of the importance of yoga in the school curriculum and how it truly goes hand in hand with education. Thank you very much. Dhanyavad.
Now I would request our chief guest to come on stage and reveal us the new book, Health and Physical Education, Teacher's Guide for Class 8.
Sabhi ko namaskar, distinguished dignitaries of the dais, honorable jury members, loving students. First of all, on my personal behalf and on behalf of NCERT, I welcome all of you for this 3 days celebration of National Yoga Olympiad as part of celebration of International Yoga Day. And all of us should be thankful to our Honorable Prime Minister and also UNESCO for declaring yoga as an international event and also celebrating Yoga Day across the world. Even the Honorable UN Secretary General, former Secretary General Ban Ki-moon, he has also categorically mentioned that yoga is going to take us a long way and to maintain health in the system, particularly in the schooling system, and also help children to attain integration of mind, body and soul. So in that way, yoga contributes a lot. If we look at the statistics today world across, more than 30 crore people are using yoga as a way of living. So, but if we consider our school education population and teacher education, we are more than 27 crore. still in India we need to popularize it more. And Professor Sarvj Yadav also rightly mentioned that yoga itself as a career can be much more helpful to our younger generation. As yoga teacher, yoga instructor, yoga researcher, our young children, youth can spread across the world and develop skill in yoga. Even internationally also, if we see the economy, today itself more than 85,000 crore economy is there as far as yoga is concerned, because we are, India is spreading across yoga across all the countries. Even it is projected in India, across the world also, by 2020 there will be 11.5 billion economy related to yoga. So in that case, India is very crucial as far as spread of yoga across the world. Coming back to India and coming back to 26 crore children in India, if we have healthy mind, it is said in a healthy body we can do much more activities. So similarly, if our children are healthy, ultimately we are going to help them to achieve the learning outcome and achieve the sustainable development goals. So let us join together and celebrate this event not as an event in a year, but on everyday life, so that we keep ourselves fit and healthy. Even our epics also, if I quote Kumarasambhavam, particularly Kalidas written in Kumarasambhavam, it has been said that Sariram Madhyam Khalu Dharma Sadhanam. So that means health is the prerequisite for all the activities. So in that case, let us join together to popularize yoga world across and keep ourselves fit and healthy and celebrate learning. Namaskar. Thank you very much.
So let's proceed to finally see the yogic activities, which first will be performed by DMS RI Ajmer.
Thank you.
Now I would request students of DMS RIE Bhubaneswar to come on the stage and perform the yogic activities.
Shri Eric Faltji, Director and UNESCO representative for India, Bhutan, Maldives and Sri Lanka, Huma Masood, Mrs. Huma Masood from UNESCO, हमारे माननीय निदेशक महोदय प्रोफेसर ऋषिकेश सेनापति जी, JDCIT प्रोफेसर रमदीन बेहरा जी, डीन महोदया प्रोफेसर सरोज यादव जी, ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स ऑफ जूरी और यहाँ पे उपस्थित NCERT परिवार के समस्त सदस्य, संकाय गण एवं हमारे समस्त अधिकारी एवं कर्मचारी गण और टेक्नीशियंस और समस्त भारत से आए हुए हमारे प्यारे बच्चों और उनके अध्यापक, सर्वप्रथम मैं पुनः, हालांकि आपका स्वागत किया जा चुका है, मैं पुनः आपका यहाँ पर एक बार फिर स्वागत करता हूँ NCERT में और आपके इस दो दिवसीय तीन दिवसीय जो महोत्सव है योगा ओलंपियाड, जो कि मेरे को विश्वास है कि आपको अपने जीवन में एक तरह का अनुभव रहेगा। और जैसे हमारे चीफ गेस्ट महोदय ने बताया कि किस प्रकार हमारे माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी की दूरदर्शिता और उनके प्रयासों के कारण हमारे इस बहुत पुरातन योग, जो कि हमारे वेदों में शास्त्रों में वर्णित है, उसको पूरे विश्व में स्थान दिया और हमारे माननीय निदेशक महोदय के प्रयासों की वजह से पिछले तीन वर्षों से NCERT इसको इसका सफलतापूर्वक संचालन करती आ रही है, जिसका कि पूरे भारत में इस समय स्थान है, इसीलिए इतने स्टूडेंट्स का नंबर हर वर्ष बढ़ता जा रहा है। प्रोफेसर डीन प्रोफेसर सरोज यादव डीन एकेडमिक्स, जिनके की कुशल निर्देशन में यह कार्य संपादित हो रहा है और दो दिन जिस तरह से आपका अभी बीतेगा आप देखोगे, जिसे मैंने कहा कि यह आपके जीवन में अविस्मरणीय क्षण रहेगा। बच्चों, योग के बारे में आप सब लोगों को बताया गया, अभी सबने इसकी महत्वता के बारे में प्रकाश डाला और छोटे बच्चों ने अभी इसका इतना कुशलता पूर्वक यहाँ पे आपके सामने परफॉर्म किया और मेरे को मालूम है कि आप में से हर एक बच्चा जो यहाँ पे आया हुआ है वह अपने में श्रेष्ठ है। तो आप यह समझो कि यहाँ पे आपका कोई कंपटीशन नहीं हो रहा है, इस किसी प्रकार की प्रतियोगिता ना समझकर आपको यहाँ पे सिर्फ भाग लेना है। और योग की महत्वता के बारे में हमारे डीन महोदया ने बताया, JDCIT ने बताया और ये आपको संपूर्ण जीवन में आपको यह मदद देने वाला है। इसकी एकाग्रता, अगर आप योग, जैसा बताया कि योग उस निराकार से और इस आकार का समन्वय है और जब आप इसको मिला देंगे तो आप अपने जीवन में हरेक कार्यों में सफल रहेंगे। मैं पुनः अपने सारे संकाय के सदस्यों को, अपने टेक्नीशियंस को, अपने समस्त कर्मचारियों को पुनः धन्यवाद देता हूं और अपने जो मीडिया के मेंबर्स हमारे यहां पे आए हुए हैं उनको भी मैं धन्यवाद देता हूं और यह आशा करता हूं कि यह दो दिन का सम्मेलन आपके लिए बहुत अच्छा साबित रहेगा आपके पूरे संपूर्ण जीवन के लिए। जय हिंद, जय भारत।